Everyone, today we are going to present about the positive and negative impacts of foreign immigrants working in the foreign land. Yeah? Suppose I am from Nepal, Uju are from Nepal, and we are working in UK. And the advantage and disadvantage of Vishal and Milan working in UK. Is that fine, sir?
Yes.
And first advantage is transfer of technology. Vishal and I work in different department of hotel. Suppose I work in reception, Vishal work in kitchen. He's a head chef, I am a receptionist.
Oh yes.
And working in UK, we can transfer our technology to our back home. Mm. Likewise, another next point is rise of tax and royalties. When we work in this country owner pay us salary, and when they pay our salary, we pay the tax. And that may be the benefit for this country. And in return, we get the money and we send that money to our back home. That may boost our economic condition as well. So it increases the remittance, and that means it is beneficial for both countries.
Actually, you are talking about this country's context, yeah?
Yeah.
This country is hiring you as the migrant worker. So what advantages does this country get from you? That's the scenario.
In this context, sir.
So let's not talk about another country, yeah, from where the migrants come.
Sir, they got enough
royalties and taxes.
So go ahead with for this country's positive points only. Yeah,
yeah, okay, sir.
At the moment. Yeah. Otherwise, it will be mixed matter.
Yes, sir. For this country, there is enough labor, sir.
Yeah. Okay.
And due to the concept of and idea I get from this country, I can develop my concept of multinational or like franchise, you know, McDonaldization. Do anybody have any confusion about McDonaldization and franchise? Everybody knows. And about the negative thing,
for this country.
Yeah, for this country.
Linking to hospitality later on anyway, but say be neutral now, yeah. In any industry.
So, talking about the negative thing, suppose Vishal is a British, I am from Nepal, and when I apply to job, most probably I get the second level job or low level job, yeah? Because Vishal is British, he gets the top level job. That may be like racism or something, yeah? Because in every organization that happens, maybe you are also familiar, yeah?
Because they give priority for the their own nationality, and it's some kind of discrimination, unethical behavior.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you must not explain this in the examination. You have to say that maybe ethical issues or language issues, yes?
Yes,
or other issues like that, yes?
Yeah,
we shouldn't write the
And the negative thing is foreign workers are forced to accept the brand standard forcefully. That means my culture in back home country and Vishal's culture in British may be different. Yeah, I am forced to accept his culture because I am in Britain and I am forced to accept the British culture and custom for the fruitful of the business. Is that okay? And I am working in Vishal country. He's British. I am working in Vishal country. Premier Inn. I am from Nepal. And if I got chance to be the top level manager or management, there may be the leakage of database and technology. Do you know the theft of database or theft of the card?
Hacking.
I think this point is important because this country is lose something because of the leakage. And then leakage of the breach of confidentiality, as you said. Maybe you may try to take the the confidential data from UK to Nepal. Yes, so that is the loss for this country because of the hiring because of the case of hiring the immigrants, isn't it?
Yes. And next thing can be cultural adaptation can be difficult. For me, it might be difficult to accept this culture.
Actually, you know what? Like you can say cultural class.
Yes, sir.
If that is your personal case, yeah. Let's not see only like labor's case only, the migrant's case only. We are looking from the country's point of view. Yes.
Yes, sir.
when this country is hiring the migrant workers, this country may have problem one day to manage the
overlapping high chance to overlap the culture.
Yeah, it may be a problem to manage the multiculturalism.
Next thing
may be the problem in this country. So that may be a negative point. Okay.
Next strong point is that suppose we are 50 people from different countries working in this country. Suppose if we all return back home, then there may be shortage. Right? There will be more people to working. That can be
good. You can explain that in another term, like the loss of skill.
Yeah.
If the country depends upon the migrants for say decades or centuries, and then this country's native manpower may be lost or get dumb because this country is not trying to encourage the natives for the expertise and only hiring means, eventually someday if the practice stops of bringing the migrants, then there is no export in this country. Yeah, that is also the negative point. Okay.
Next negative point can be that there may be the brain drain problem in poor countries.
Okay. Yes, brain drain is somehow similar to the previous point. Yeah?
Do everybody understand the keyword of brain drain?
No, sir.
Normally, the brain drain means when you are educated in your country makes you some art skill. And when you give something return to your country, you don't stay in your country and go to foreign land for your livelihood, for your earnings. That means that is lost for your country. That is better.
Your definition, definition, up to you. Okay, good. Okay.
And, sir, last question.
Okay.
Last answer.
No question. No, we don't need question. Answer, please.
And next can be the environmental factor. When people from different parts of the world come here, there may be the pollution or maybe something like
crowd,
terrorism, something. Different culture, just there may be something problem,
Environmental problem. You can explain more. Yeah, that's
right. Okay. So that's it, sir.
Yeah, criminality.
Criminality.
And then kind of things. Street criminality, street violence, etc. Yeah. Okay. Okay, thank you so much. Yeah, well, we have to say.